Hello everyone. So in today's lecture, we are going to solve linear programming problem using graphical method. Okay. In last example, we have solved two constraint linear programming problem. In today's lecture, we are going to solve three constraint linear programming problem using graphical method. So our first step is to consider inequalities as an equation. So here I am having three inequalities. So first is x1 plus 2x2 is equals to 2000. Next is x1 plus x2 is equals to 1500. And third is x2 is equals to 600. So I converted all inequalities in equation. So I get three line equations. Now, second step in graphical method is, as we have seen, that graphical method is applicable only when we are having two decision variables. So here I am having x1 and x2 as my decision variable. That's why we can plot it in two dimension space. Okay. So now we will find out for each equation the coordinates and then plot them on graph. Okay. So for equation 1. x1 plus 2x2 is equals to 2000. Put x1 is equals to 0, so you will get x2 is equals to 1000 value. Okay. Similarly, when you put x2 is equals to 0 in this equation, you will get x1 is equals to 2000. Okay. So what are the coordinates for equation 1? x1 and x2, I am having two quadrants. Coordinates are, when x1 is 0, my x2 is 1000. When x2 is 0, x1 is 2000. Okay. So these are coordinates for equation 1. Now I am having equation 2. x1 plus x2 is equals to 1500. Okay, so put x1 is equals to 0, x2 is equals to 1500, you will get in from this equation. When you put x2 is equals to 0 in this equation, x1 is equals to 1500. So what are the coordinates? Coordinates for this equations are 0 and 1500. X2 is 0, x1 is 1500. Okay, these are the coordinates for equation 2. For equation 3, x2 is equals to 600. So basically it's a line, it's a straight line parallel to x-axis. When my x2 is 60. Okay, so I got three line equations and these two will give me information that my plot will be in first quadrant. Okay, so now we will plot these lines in graph. Okay, so my first line was x1 plus 2x2 equals to 2000. Coordinate is when my x1 is 0, when x1 is 0, then x2 is 1000. This point I will get. When x2 is 0, I will get 2000 as x1. So I will join these two points, I will get this line for my equation 1. Okay, now comes second equation. Second equation is, first point is 0 and 150 and another point is 150 and 0. So this will give me line for equation 2. Last I am having x2 is equals to 600. So this line with peach color, which is parallel to the x-axis, is for my equation 3. So I plotted all three lines And for x1 equals to 0, I will get this line. This one is for x1 is equals to 0. Sorry, x2 is equals to 0. This one is x1 is equals to 0. This one is x2 is equals to 0. So I got these 5 lines. So now I have to shade the feasible reason. So for first equation, where it is less than means, as I talked earlier, below the line reason will give me the feasible reason. So in this area below the line is my feasible reason for equation 1. Okay, now for equation 2, the area below this line, because again it's less than, again this area below this line is my feasible reason. Okay, for next line, this again it's less than, so below this line is my feasible reason. Okay, and for other two equations, this whole quadrant, first quadrant, for this it's on this side, and for this line it's above this line, so this whole first quadrant will be my feasible reason. So what is a feasible reason for this of problem? My feasible reason is common reason for all the lines. So this yellow shaded reason is my feasible reason. Okay, so now I got the feasible reason. What is my next step? Next step is to find the coordinates of corner points of my feasible reason. So this yellow shaded reason is my feasible reason. So I have to mark my corner point. So first is origin. Origin is my corner point. Second corner point is given by, I assume this as A. A is 0 and 600. Okay. Then another corner point is this point, where B is 1500, 0. Now I have to find out these two points, these two corner points. So first corner point, the C point, I will get by solving equation as we have seen earlier. This is the line for equation 1. This is line for equation 2. Okay, and third line is for my equation 3. Okay, so now I have to find out corner point. Suppose C I have to find out. So in that case, I have to solve which two equations? Red one and the peach one. Red one is equation 1 and peach one is equation 3. Solve these two equations simultaneously will give me the point value of cross section. So this is my cross section point. So my equation is x1 plus 2x2 is equals to 2000. That was my first equation. Third equation is x2 is equals to 600. Okay, so put x2 is equals to 600 in this equation, you will get x1 is equals to 2000 minus 600 into 2 is 1200. So x1 value is 800. Okay, so for the C point, my values are x1 value is 800 and x2 value is 600. So that's my fourth corner point. Again, the last D corner point, if I want to find out it, I can get by solving equation 1, red one and black one. So equation 1 and equation 2 simultaneously. Okay, so my first equation is again 1 plus 2x2 is equals to 200, 2000, and another was, second equation was x1, x2 is equals to 1500. Okay, now solve them. I will subtract equation 3, second from equation 1, so this will get cancelled out. I will get x2 is equals to 500. Put value of x2 in equation 3, you will get 1 is equals to 1500 minus 500, which is equals to 1000. Okay, so D point, corner point coordinates are 1000, x1 value, and x2 value is 500. So I got 5 corner points, O, A, C, D, B. So my feasible reason is O, A, B, C, D, or you can say O, A, C, D, B. It's the same thing. Okay, so I will just clear out this thing once. A feasible reason is, I'm writing it here, O, A, C, D, B. Okay, so after that I will plot my coordinates and find the corner coordinates, that is O is equals to 0, 0. Second coordinate is A is equals to 0, 600. Third quadrant is 1500, 0. Fourth quadrant, we have find out 800 and 600. And last corner point is 1500. Okay, so by solving it, we will get the objective function value corresponding to each coordinate. So z0 will be, if I put x1 is equals to 0, x2 is equals to 0, z0 is 0. Now we will find out objective function corresponding to a point. Okay, so 3 into 0 plus 5 into 600 will give me value of objective function as 3000. Next is ZB is equals to 3 into 1500 x1 value, then x2 value is 0, so 5 into 0, so its equation is, when you solve this equation, ZB is 4500. Next objective function value will be 3 into x1, x1 is 800 and x2 is 600. So when you solve it, this is how much, 2400. Next is 3000, so you will get the value as 54,000. 5400. Okay, and similarly we can calculate for D point, 3 into 1000 plus 5 into 500. So what is the value you are getting? 3000 plus 2500, you will get 5500. Okay, so next since we know this problem is maximization problem, so corresponding to each point we will see which one is maximum objective function we are getting. So corresponding to D point we are getting maximum objective function. So my objective function maximum of this is maximization problem, so objective function, maximum objective function is Z is equals to 5500. And optimal solution is when x1 value is 1000 and x2 value is 500. Okay, so that's how we solve linear programming problem for three constraint using graphical method. Okay, so that's all for today's lecture. Thank you.